especially, I mean, for the pop gigs that you've been doing since then,
yeah,
reggae is something that, like, give this a reggae feel. That must come up quite
yeah,
a lot.
Yeah, I've done it a few times, actually. The Jason Mraz album had a bit of reggae vibe. I've just done James Blunt's latest single is a bit of that as well.
Right.
Ollie Murs, definitely got a bit of that in there. Mm-hmm. Heart Skips a Beat.
Okay.
That's right.
Yeah.
Yeah, so it's out there, but it's just nice to have those influences and know how to turn it on if you can. And that's why doing this gig is nice, because I just feel as a session drummer, if that's what you are and that's what you do, the more styles of music you've got in your locker, the better, really.
Absolutely.
But I still wouldn't be able to walk into a pit gig tomorrow and just play off the bat. You know, I've got fast ears and I could listen to it, but maybe the reading thing is the next thing I should really get into, because why not, you know?
Yeah. I mean, it sounds as if you definitely have found a niche, you know. You've found people, you are, you know, on speed dial as...
Speed dial session drummer.
Yeah, for a lot of artists and producers. So.
I think what's happened in that, young drummers bursting onto the scene now, and I get a lot of emails and questions, and the million-dollar question, how do I become a session drummer? How do I get into the scene? How do I meet producers? Is there an agency I can speak to, or this, that, and the other? I've never really got... I've had one session in my whole career for an agent, for studio. But I think, and I'm glad to say, I think studio and recording is about reputation, and your playing gets documented on records. People hear you, people think, oh, that's nice, I'd like to use him. Someone might come to the gig tonight and see me playing, and that's happened a few times, where someone's called me up and said, I've seen you playing, love you to come and do this. And I think that's the only way that the scene works. I think if you're out there playing as much as you can and you're good, and I'm not blowing smoke here, I'm saying if you do something that people like and that's recognisable, I think it works for itself.
Yeah.
I don't think, and I'd like all the young drummers or the young up and coming session players, they should really just know that and put themselves, I think you can't really make one phone call and expect everything to fall into place.
Yeah,
it just doesn't.
To put yourself out there.
I wanted to be
possible.
A recording drummer, but I didn't know who to speak to, and thankfully, like I talked about doing an audition for Guy all those years ago, I had a link with him, and we got to meet again, and I have to thank Guy. I played on some great records thanks to Guy, and and there's a good circle of producers that I work for.
Yeah,
and I'm a bit of a workaholic. I love the kit. I just love playing, especially on record. And if I get asked to do something, unless I physically can't get there, I'll always normally make it happen if I can.
Yeah.
I mean,
as proof today, because I mean you've done sessions this morning and last.
Well, today I've been today. This morning I did a session, and then yesterday I did two sessions, and then I produced a track for 5 seconds or something.
Amazing.
Which is
is in the middle of a massive.
Well, it was a day. It's effectively a day off, but because it's been so busy, you kind of only get short windows to put stuff in. And thankfully, we're in London, so I've been able to run around and do stuff. I probably should have had a day of rest, but then I'd be lying in bed feeling guilty, having said no to something. So I'll wait till I'm 50 odd to do that. I think.
Well, listen. You've got to get rehearsing.
Well, aren't you going to ask me some questions?
I tried. Just quickly tell us, I mean, do you have anything else in the pipeline that we need to hear about?
Quick update on what I'm doing. I have just played on some new Ollie Murs tracks for his record. I've just done a record, some tracks for Ella Henderson. Currently musical director for 5 Seconds of Summer, who I'm very proud of, because I don't play in that band. I was just kind of they don't really need me, to be honest. They're great players. Very smart young boys that are massive all of a sudden. They've blown up overnight. But I helped them craft a show for the UK tour, and I've ended up doing some B-sides with them in the studio.
Nice.
Great bunch of lads. It's nice not to be playing the kit and just be passing on a bit of knowledge and experience. But they're super, super good band. I mean, two guitars, bass, drums. Drummer's really good. Definitely one to watch. Ashton Irwin, he's quite a big chap, well set, but he really hits the kit. He's got great technique, and it reminds me of when I was young. You can see his ability growing so quick, so fast. He does the odd fill, and you just turn around and go, "Is that? What was that?" But they're a great band and they're lovely to work with. So I've enjoyed that side of things because it's been different. When I've MD gigs before, I've always been playing. Mm-hmm. I kind of not, I prefer not to, if I'm going to MD, I prefer not to play kit. Just and this is this has been the perfect scenario.
Right, yeah.
So lots of, doing lots of different, I've just done an album with Grant Nicholas from Feeder.
Yeah, yeah.
And I'm hoping to do some gigs with Grant.
I did wonder because I'd seen that he was releasing new material.
Like, yeah, well, it's sadly it's clashed with Robbie's Australian dates and mm-hmm. stuff, but Grant's cool and we've done, I really think he's done an amazing record. We've recorded it all together in Angelic Studios. Mm-hmm. And I think it's one of the best things he's done.
Great.
I really do. I'm not saying that because I'm playing on it, but I've been a part of the whole process. Mm. The songs are great, the production's mega, and it's very different from the Feeder stuff we've done. It's not out and out rock. We've really concentrated on drum sounds, weird drum sounds, different approach again, like baggy snares, playing the snare upside down, hitting the springs, all sorts of stuff.
Nice.
But it sounds great, and the song content is great. I'm hoping that I get to do some shows with him next year, but whilst he's doing the promo, I think he's going to be doing stripped down things, but that's definitely an album you should have a listen to.
We will.
And I've just done an album with Jamie Scott. Jamie Scott and the Town was a band I was in a few years ago.
Right, yeah.
He's releasing it in America, but it's very Ray Lamontagne sort of country vibe. But
nice.
Really enjoyed doing that because again, it was a live record that we all cut together. And I'm going to be hitting the road with James for a bit and Robbie, and that's pretty much going to see me to Christmas shopping if I get a chance.
September then.
Yeah, so yeah, I'm out until I get December off.
Yeah.
So that'll be nice to do some family stuff. And
great.
Next year, who knows? Who knows? But I'm just loving, I'm really grateful and loving the train that I'm on at the minute. And
yeah. Well, we're grateful for your time because it's obviously very precious and you don't get a lot of it.
No,
so.
I love doing stuff like this because. I'm not an egomaniac and love talking about myself, but I know what it's like. When I was a young drummer and I used to buy rhythm, I used to sit there and just look at adverts and just be loving drums and interested in the scene and what goes on. And just being on Rhythm Front cover this month was a real sort of pinch yourself for me because I was like a kid. Dad,
yeah,
look,
yeah.
Look. He says, "Is that you?" I said, "Yeah." And that was nice, but I just think anyone that's going to be watching this or listening, yeah. I hope they find it interesting and can relate to stuff I've said, you know, joking
yeah,
aside.
I hope so, and I think, you know, you've got a lot to teach people, not just when it comes to playing and feel and groove, but how to conduct yourself on tour, personality.
Yeah, all that's
just,
part of it.
Yeah, that's obviously why you're as hireable as you are and why you're as successful as you are.
It's definitely not your boat race.
It's all the ponytail.
Yeah, God, I've got it in a paper bag if you want it.
It's not framed. Right.
Listen, thanks for coming in today. I've really enjoyed chatting to you.
Great to meet you.
It's been nice to tell you about my story, really.
Yeah.
But I hope you've enjoyed it. It's been really nice.
We really have. Do stay in touch. We'll make sure we've got links to all of your projects on the page and, you know, any videos you want to send our way, that kind of thing, any cassette tapes.
Great.
That would be great.
Thank you, iDrum. Been a lovely afternoon. See you again.
Thanks for watching, guys. Carl Brazil.
Bye.